Most men go into politics with a real desire to help his fellow men and to become famous doing it. Mind you, there's nothing wrong with having the ambition to become famous. I've had that ambition all my life. And even now while I'm speaking, though it won't be heard except from the grave, I hope that what I'm saying will cause people to say, well, Joey wasn't too bad. He made his mistakes, of course he did. But his heart was in the right place, and that's a good ambition for a public man to have.
Although he was born in Gambo in central Newfoundland, most of Joey Smallwood's early years were spent in St. John's, where the family moved in search of a better way of life.
Poverty, I saw lots of it. And I saw it and felt it in the place where you remembered all your life, not here, but here, in the stomach. And I expect we all did, this family of 13 children.
The St. John's of Smallwood's youth centered around the commercial activity of Water Street. Smallwood attended several St. John's schools, but he quit in the ninth grade and took the first in a series of jobs with St. John's newspapers. He eventually landed a reporter's job with the Evening Telegram and made a name for himself covering transatlantic plane flights. But Smallwood was restless. Via reporter's jobs in Halifax and Boston, he landed in New York at the age of 20 and began work at a socialist newspaper. While in New York, he took socialism to heart, taking in lectures and reading voraciously. But Newfoundland beckoned. 5 years after he went to New York, he returned home to organize workers at the Corner Brook and Grand Falls paper mills. Back home, he met his future wife, Clara Oates of Carbonear. They married and started a family that grew to two sons and a daughter. Like most families in Newfoundland during the Depression, the Smallwoods found it hard to eke out a living.